Hello everyone, this is Abhita Sharma, your biology teacher. Let's start our class with short prayer. Dear God, please shower your blessings upon each one of us. Topic for today is Introducing Biology, Scope and Branches. Students, our Earth is the most beautiful planet. Yes, we have lots of beautiful creations. We have got varieties of plant, varieties of animal and microorganisms. So biology is the branch of science which deals with the study of all these living organisms. And to understand each organism in a proper way, to understand each organism in a better way, they have divided this biology into different branches. Today we are going to talk about the different branches of biology. Let's start with biology. What is biology? Biology is the combination of two Greek words, bios meaning life and logos meaning study. So biology is the branch of science which deals with the study of what? Life, living organisms. And the word biology was first coined by French naturalist Lamarck. Okay, and our next scientist, Aristotle, he made most of the biological observation. He identified many plants and animals. That's why he is known as the father of biology. Okay. Now we have different branches of biology. In terms of major kinds of organism, we have three branches of biology. What are they? They are botany, zoology and human biology. Botany is the branch of biology which deals with the study of plant life. Okay, branch of biology which deals with the study of plant life is called botany. Next we have zoology. Zoology is the branch of biology which deals with the study of what? Animals, animal life. Next we have human biology. Human biology is the branch of biology which deals with the study of human beings and their relationship with environment, with both physical and social environment. And this human biology is also called anthropology. Next we have different branches on how we study an organism. Okay, so first one is anatomy. When we study an organism by dissecting it, it becomes our what? Anatomy. Figure on your screen is the anatomy of what? Frog. Here we have dissected frog from its anterior position, and now we can study the different structures, different organs which are present inside the frog. Yes, so study of an organism, okay, by dissecting it from its anterior position is what? Anatomy. Next we have morphology. Morphology is the approach of studying, okay, when we study an organism in terms of size, shape, okay, structure, color, it becomes our morphology. Okay, and when we study all this size, shape and structures of an organism which are present outside, okay, when we study the outside features, okay, external features, it becomes your external morphology. And when we study, okay, the structures of an organism which are present inside, in terms of its size, shape and structure, it becomes your what? Internal morphology. Next we have cytology. Cytology is the branch of biology which deals with the study of what? Cells. Study of cells. And what are these cells? Cell is the structural and functional unit of life. Yes, all the living organisms are what? Made up of what? Cells. And the branch of biology which deals with the study of cell is called what? Cytology. Next we have histology. Histology is the branch of biology which deals with the study of tissues. So what are tissues? When a group of cells unite, or when they aggregate together to perform a specific function, is called a tissue. Okay, so tissues are what? tissue is a group of cells, okay, group of similar cells. When they aggregate and perform together or perform a similar function, it becomes your tissue. And the branch of biology which deals with the study of this tissue, okay, is called histology. Next we have physiology. Physiology is the branch of biology which deals with the study of functions of different organs and organ system, like how heart functions in our body, okay, how heart functions in an organism, how our digestive system works, how our kidneys work, okay. So the functions of different organs and organ system in our body is physiology, okay. Physiology is the branch of biology which deals with the study of functions of different organs and organ system. Next we have embryology. Embryology is the branch of biology which deals with the study of embryonic development of an organism, okay. What are the changes that occurs during the embryonic development, okay, how an organism develop, okay, in its embryonic stage, okay. So it's the branch of biology which deals with the study of organism in its embryonic stage. Next we have a taxonomy. In taxonomy, what they do, they identify an organism, okay, they identify organism and then they place the organism in certain group, okay, they give name to an organism. So taxonomy is the branch of a biology which deals with the identification, naming and a placing an organism into a particular group, okay. And ecology is the branch of biology which deals with the study of living organisms and its relationship with environment, okay, relationship of plants and animals with each other, relationship of animals among themselves and their relationship with environment, okay, physical environment like water, land, okay, air, so on. So ecology is the branch of biology which deals with the study of living organisms and its relationship with its physical factors or physical environment. Next we have biogeography, okay. Biogeography is the branch of biology which deals with the study of bio, means living organism, in respect to geographical distribution. Next we have paleontology. Paleontology is the branch of biology, okay, which deals with the study of prehistoric life. It deals with the study of an organisms which were once living and now they are extinct, okay. And this paleontology study is done with the help of fossils, okay. Evolution is the branch of biology which deals with the study of how life originated on earth and how simple forms, okay, simple living organisms, it changes into a complex form, or I can say a more developed one, okay, how a simple organism changes into a more developed or a complex form. Next we have genetics. Genetics is the branch of biology which deals with the transfer of a characters, okay, branch of biology which deals with the transfer of a characters from one generation to next generation, okay, transfer of a characters from parents to their children. Next we have a parasitology. Parasitology is the branch of biology which deals with the study of parasites, and there are two types of parasites, ectoparasites and endoparasites. Ectoparasites are the parasites which lives on the external surface of another organism, and endoparasites, it lives inside the body of another organism. So parasitology is the branch of biology which deals with the study of this parasites and the relationship between parasites and host, okay. Next we have immunology. Immunology is the branch of biology which deals with the study of how our immune system works, okay, how our body fights against different germs or different foreign bodies like a virus and bacteria, okay, how our body fight against foreign bodies okay, that is immunology. Okay, immunology is the branch of biology which deals with the study of immune system. Okay, how our body fights with different foreign organisms. Okay, foreign bodies like a virus and bacteria. Next we have a biochemistry. Bio means life, and in chemistry we study mostly about the chemicals. So in biochemistry is also a branch of biology which deals with the study of an organism in its molecular level. Okay, when we study an organism, when we study the chemical composition of an organism, when we study an organism in its molecular level, this is called what? Biochemistry. Okay, now again we have different branches of biology in terms of special group of organisms. Okay, so let's start with bacteriology. Bacteriology is the branch of biology which deals with the study of what? Bacteria. Okay, bacteriology deals with the study of bacteria. Next we have virology. Virology is the branch of biology which deals with the study of what? Virus. Next we have mycology. It's a branch of biology which deals with the study of fungi. Okay, next we have phycology. Phycology is also called algology, and this is the branch of biology which deals with the study of what? Algae. Next we have ichthyology. It's a branch of biology which deals with the study of fish. And next we have herpetology. Herpetology is the branch of biology which deals with the study of reptiles and lizards. Next we have ornithology. Ornithology is the branch of biology which deals with the study of what? Birds. This much for today. In our next class, we will discuss about different more branches of biology. Thank you.